بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، صلى الله وسلم وبارك على عبده ورسوله سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، إخواني في الله، اتقوا الله ربكم في يولود واشكروه على ما سخر لكم من مخلوقاته، ومن ذلك الشمس والقمر. قال الله عز وجل: وسخر لكم الشمس والقمر دائبين وسخر لكم الليل والنهار. سخرهما من أجلكم يسيران بنظام بديع وسير سريع، الشمس والقمر بحسبان لا يختلفان ولا ينحرفان ولا يتغيران عما قدر الله لهما في ذلك، صنع الله الذي أتقن كل شيء. وهما آيتان من آيات الله دالتان على كمال علمه وقدرته، آيتان في عظمهما ونورهما وإضاءتهما. تبارك الذي جعل في السماء بروجا وجعل فيها سراجا وقمرا منيرا، آيتان من آيات الله في سيرهما وانتظامهما، والشمس تجري لمستقر لها، ذلك تقدير العزيز العليم، والقمر قدرناه منازل حتى عاد كالعرجون القديم. لا الشمس ينبغي لها أن تدرك القمر، ولا الليل سابق النهار، وكل في فلك يسبحون. I'm going to speak in English inshallah to give a chance to everyone to understand. But when I come to the important point, just I'm talking now about the sun and the moon. Allah Azza Jal created them because for you, to benefit you, to guide you, to give light for you, okay? And we should thank Him, obey Him, praise Him, okay? Then a sign about the full knowledge of Allah, full power of Allah, full mercy of Allah. Sign through their light. Sign, see how going, coming, since when Allah Azza wa Jal created them till the day of judgment. No problem with them at all. Every day the sun rise and set, normal. No one look after it except Him. It's a big, big sign. If someone ask you, how do you know your Lord? بما عرفت ربك. How did you know your Lord? فقل بآياته ومخلوقاته. Say, I know my Lord through His signs and the creation. ومن آياته الليل والنهار والشمس والقمر. From His signs, day and night, and the sun and the moon. ومن مخلوقاته السماوات السبع والأرضين السبع. From His creation, seven skies and seven earth. See this sun, this moon. Both of them worshiping Allah Azza wa Jal. But some stupid people worship them. Like the queen of Yemen, Balqis. That bird find out that some people with their queen worshiping sun. And the bird rise up this issue to Sulaiman alayhi salam. Then Sulaiman send letter to them. Come as a Muslim, otherwise I will be there. Then they come. The queen embraces Islam. قالت ربي إني ظلمت نفسي. Oh my Lord, I oppress myself. When I worship other than you, وأسلمت مع سليمان لله رب العالمين. I enter Islam with سليمان عليه السلام. طيب, this people of Ibrahim too worshiping stars, sun, moon, stars. But themselves worshiping Allah Azza wa Jal. Even, do you think when you see something great and you like it, mean that you should worship it? People in India, they worship cow. 300 something religion in India only worship rat, mouse, anything other than Allah Azza wa Jal. What the people living in the previous Islam, before Islam, ignorance days? We are in 20th century. All the world changed. The one who is away from his deen come back to Allah Azza wa Jal. Day after day, people find out that Allah is the real Lord. See what happened in India lately? After Corona attack everyone, they look at the Buddha, big statue, small statue, different color, different. Doesn't benefit them at all. Then what they did? They start broken it. If you didn't see it, go to YouTube and you see it. Okay. قال, the light of the sun and the moon come by the will of Allah. When he, subhanahu wa ta'ala, want to put fee in the heart of his servant, he will extinguish the light of the sun and the moon. Completely or some of it. No more light. Let all the people with their technology to put the light back or to block it. They're not be able out of the hand. But when Allah Azza wa Jal want to put fee in the heart of his servant as warning, because no more messenger come to warn the people. No more angel descend to warn the people. Only put fee through the sign. Everyone can see it. Sun and the moon. So he eclipsed the sun and the moon. He want his servant to rise up the head and see what happened to the sun and moon. Where's the light of it? Gone. Who take it away? The one who created them. Aha, the Lord, Allah Azza wa Jal. Maybe they give up and come back to Allah Azza wa Jal. Maybe they keep away from the haram. When this time, as you can see, the eclipse increased. يعني yearly, more than time. Why? Because a lot of sin, or evil deeds the people committing, the people swim today in the sin, follow their desire, forget the hereafter. يعني what? Enjoy themselves, destroy their deen, come towards the world, go away from the hereafter. Subhanallah, even this sign, some people take it lightly or easy. Some people think, what's going on? Oh, eclipse. So eclipse, or let go and take some photo. Some people like this. Come, have a look. Have a look, have a look, have a look. What happened to the light of the sun and the moon? They have different opinion before. Before, they believe an eclipse happened when someone great die or someone great born. Today, some people believe that eclipse happened because what? Because whale want to eat the moon. البحوت عم يبلع القمر, عم يسولو. طيب, what's the solution? Two ways. Either shoot, use machine gun to kill the whale, or to use a drum, a طبل, بطبلو. Up to today. When the sun, when the eclipse of the sun happened during the time of the Prophet ﷺ, what happened? It was on the same day of his son Ibrahim passed away. It was the hottest day. After the sunrise, يعني during الضحى time, after one رمح, and the eclipse happened. And the news reached the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. At the end of his life. At the end of his life, صلى الله عليه وسلم. Sun become like قطعة نحاس. قطعة نحاس, piece of met, what نحاس? Silver. Copper. لا, copper, الفضة. Huh? Silver, what is silver? Copper. يعني like just piece of copper, that's it. No more light. Then the Prophet ﷺ get up. He's يعني very scared that he after come and the hour come. يعني كان القيامة قامت. And him and his companion rush to the masjid. To let you know how he was fee, صلى الله عليه وسلم, how he was scared too much. He used to drag, he's come out from his home dragging his garment. And by mistake, he takes the garment of his wife, not his garment. While he's going to the masjid, drop from him. Until, as Asma said, we send his garment behind him. قال أخطأ فلبس رداء إحدى نسائه حتى أدركه بردائه. حتى رداءه سقط على الأرض. ولم يشعر به من شدة فزعه وخوفه. قالت أسماء رضي الله عنها فأخطأ بدرع حتى أدرك بردائه بعد ذلك. When he arrived to the masjid, asked some of his companions to call the people. الصلاة جامعة. الصلاة in congregation. Come. The people coming. Men, women, boys, girls, everyone. Then he صلى الله عليه وسلم lead them in strange prayer. صلاة غريبة. With people crying. Weeping. Out of fear from Allah Azza wa Jal. That is as evidence that everyone was scared, even him صلى الله عليه وسلم. He pray a prayer never ever prayed before. And he used to command his companion if someone leads them in the prayer to make it short. But in this time, he do the opposite one. Long prayer. قال جابر فأطال القيام حتى جعلوا يخرون. He standing until his companions start falling down and sitting on the floor. أسماء رضي الله عنها said فأطال رسول الله القيام جدا. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم stand long standing حتى تجلاني الغشي until become unconscious. فأخذت قربة من ماء إلى جنبي. She took يعني bucket of water. والله yes, next to me, I start to pour water on my head, on my face, to wake up. فالنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قام فيهم قياما طويلا, long standing, all his company behind him. He prayed a prayer never ever. They know it. He never prayed like similar prayer. ورسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قائم في مقامه يتلو كتاب الله. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم standing, reciting the book of Allah. Why? لأن هذه آية عظيمة. Because this is a great sign. Allah put fear in the heart of his servant. Warn them that he's so angry. For this is a warning from Allah to his servant. During his prayer, something happened. What happened? He saw the hellfire and paradise through his eyes, real. While he was praying, Allah Azza wa Jal allowed him to see paradise and the hellfire. And he saw some people punishing in the hellfire. And he knew them. Well, I'm going to tell you who are they and what sin they commit. While he's praying, go forward. Then come back. Go forward. When he saw the paradise, try to take branch of grape. When he go back, he saw the hellfire. When he finished the prayer, get up in front of his companion, give them a talk. Praise his Lord. وحمد الله وأثنى عليه ما هو أدنى ثم قال أما بعد فإن الشمس والقمر آيتان من آيات الله يخوف الله بهما عباده. The sun and the moon is two signs of Allah عز وجل. Put fear in the heart of his servant to see who's among them going to repent. وإنهما لا ينكسفان لموت أحد ولا لحياته. The eclipse will not because for life of someone or death of someone. فإذا رأيتم ذلك فافزعوا إلى الصلاة. When you see the eclipse, rush to the prayer. Two, supplication. Two, ask forgiveness. فادعوا الله. Ask your Lord. كبروا وتصدقوا. Say الله أكبر and give charity. حتى يفرج الله عنكم. وإن another issue حتى ينجلي. Until the light come back to the sun and the moon. Then he said, Ya Ummata Muhammad, O the servant of Muhammad, Wallahi ma min ahadin aghyaru min Allahi an yazniya abduhu aw tazniya amatuhu. Ya Ummata Muhammad, Wallahi law ta'lamuna ma a'lam la dhahiktum qalilan wa la bakaytum kathira wa la ma talazzaztum bin nisa'i 'ala al-furush wa la kharajtum ila as-su'udat taj'aruna ila Allahi 'azza wa jalla. وأيم الله يعني والله لقد رأيت منذ قمت ما أنتم لاقوه من أمر دنياكم وآخرتكم ما من شيء لم أكن رأيته إلا رأيته في مقامي هذا حتى الجنة والنار رأيت النار يحطم بعضها بعضا فلم أرك اليوم منظرا قط أفظع إلى آخر موعظته البليغة صلى الله عليه وسلم. I'm going to translate this one because one of this from four great sin he warned his ummah through his speech. For what is obligatory upon us, upon the servant of Allah, to fear Allah Azza wa Jal, to cry, to repent, to give charities, to increase their forgiveness, to show they are so poor to the mercy of Allah, increase everything good deeds. Help the orphan, the widow, rush to the prayer. For eclipse itself is warning from Allah Azza wa Jalla to his servant. Only the punishment will come, just only need something other from Allah Azza wa Jalla. Do you remember the people of Yunus? When he get angry from them and left them, Allah wait, the punish coming. Really, yes, the punishment, the torment come inside the cloud, the fire inside it. They think it's a cloud and rain in it. فَلَمَّا رَوْهُ عَارِضًا مُسْتَقْبِلَ أَوْدَيْهُ قَالُوا هَذَا عَارِضٌ مُطَرِّنَا بَلَا وَمَا اسْتَعْجَلْتُ بِهِ رِيحٌ فِيهَا عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ تُدَمِّرُ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ بِأَمْرِ رَبِّهَا فَأَصْبَحُوا لَا يُرَى إِلَّا مَسَاكِنُهُمْ. قال إلا قوم يونس لما آمنوا كشفنا عنهم عذاب الخزي في الحياة الدنيا ومتعناهم إلى حين. When they see the punishment coming in the way above them, they come out, men, women, children, animals, everything, rise up their hand to Allah. Ya Allah, خلاص, enough is enough, we repent, we give up, no more statue, no more worshiping other than you. Then Allah Azza wa Jalla remove the punishment, save them. Then he, as he saved his prophet in the whale, in the stomach of the whale, after 3 days he sent him back to them and all of them in taste. فَأَرْسَلْنَاهُ إِلَى مِئَةِ أَلْفٍ أَوْ يَزِيدُونَ. Then we sent him to 100,000 and more. فَآمَنُوا. All of them into Islam. And the big eye behind this warning, and the people come back to Allah Azza wa Jalla. And he, Subhanahu wa ta'ala, said, وَمَا نُرْسِلُ بِالْآيَاتِ إِلَّا تَخْوِيفَ. And we sent not the sign except as a warning. Okay, Today, my brothers, during his khutbah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what he said? He saw some people through his eyes in the hellfire. Okay, there are four great sins. He, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, warned his ummah after he saw the people receiving punishment in the hellfire. Okay, four sins. First, associating punishment with Allah Azza wa Jalla, shirk. Number two, killing, murder, kill some innocent people. Number three, adultery, zina. Number four, stealing. الشرك والقتل والزنا والسرقة. As for shirk, he warned his ummah from shirk when he said, رأيت عمرو بن عامر الخزاعي يجر قصبه في النار, أي يجر أمعاءه في النار, كان أول من سيب السوائب. He, صلى الله عليه وسلم, said, I saw عمر بن عامر الخزاعي dragging his intestines, يعني stomach, in the fire, for he was the first man who started the custom of releasing animals for the sake of false gods. Some animal, Allah stop this for our statue, not allowed anyone to slaughter it or to ride it. And he was the first man changed the religion of Ibrahim alayhi salam. And he called people to worship idols. Change the fitrah of the people, who changed the religion of Ibrahim, where people start worshiping idols. Even inside the Kaaba, around the Kaaba, was a 360 statue when the Prophet salam opened Mecca. With shirk is a sin that Allah will not forgive it. If you meet Allah with shirk, He will not forgive you. Hellfire forever, whomever you are. No difference between worshiping idols or grave or human. At the end, you worship another than Allah, and the worship is the right of Allah Azza wa Jal. As Allah said, وَأَنَّ الْمَسَاجِدَ لِلَّهِ فَلَا تَعْدُوا مَعَ اللَّهِ أَحَدًا. Here the first scene. What is it? Shirk. فكيب away from shirk as much as you can to save yourself from the hellfire forever. Number two, وحذر النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم من جريمة القتل بغير حق. He warned his nation from killing someone innocent without right. And he said in his speech, رأيت فيها, أي في النار, امرأة من بني إسرائيل تعذب في هرة لها ربطتها فلم تطعمها ولم تدعها تأكل أو تأكل من خشاش الأرض كما في مسلم وعند النساء حتى ماتت. He, صلى الله عليه وسلم, said, and I saw in the fire a woman belonging to the tribe of Israel who was tormented for a act who for a cat who was tormented for a cat whom she had tied but did not give it food, nor set it free to eat the creatures of the earth until it died. Cat, innocent. Put it in a cage, tied it, don't provide for it, no food, no drink, even didn't left it to eat from the creatures in the earth until she died. A woman kill indirectly cat. He saw in the hellfire. What he say for people killing innocent of human, innocent Muslim, innocent children, innocent women, like what happened recently in Gaza. Do you think, you know, this servant, يعني, a sheep like this, do you think that you have authority to kill whomever you want? If you dislike it, wallah, one day you're coming back to your Lord. And you stand up with, as a murderer, with the one you kill him. Oh Allah, this man killed me, ask him why he killed me. Then each one will take his right. Will no one help you? Fakir power, don't kill anyone, huh? Number three,
وحذر النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم من الزنا. He warned his ummah from adultery, so from illegal sexual intercourse. When he said, يا أمة محمد والله ما من أحد أغير من الله أن يزني عبده أو تزني أمته. يا أمة محمد والله لو تعلمون ما أعلم لضحكتم قليلا ولبكيتم كثيرا. نريد إن صحيح البخاري. Allah's Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said, oh followers of Muhammad, there is none who has a greater sense of ghira, يعني self-respect, than Allah. So he has forbidden that his slave commits illegal sexual intercourse, or his slave girl commits illegal sexual intercourse, or followers of Muhammad, if you but knew what I know, you would laugh less and weep more. And Allah Azza wa Jalla said, وَلَا تَقْرَبُوا الزِّنَا. He didn't say don't commit illegal intercourse. He said do not come near zina. إِنَّهُ كَانَ فَاحِشَةً وَسَاءَ سَبِيلًا. The great sin. And number four in the last, وَحَذَّرَ النَّبِي صَلَى أُمَّتَهُ مِنَ السَّرِقَةِ وَهِيَ أَكْلُ أَمَالَ سَبْلَطِلْ. He warned his ummah from taking the wealth of others without right. فَقَالَ فِي خُطْبَتِهِ تِلْكَ رأيت فيها أي في النار صاحب المحجن يجر قصبه في النار. كان يسرق الحجاج بمحجنه فإن فطن له قال إنما تعلق بمحجنه وإن غفل عنه ذهب به كما راه مسلم. He صلى الله عليه وسلم said, and I saw the owner of the covered staff, صاحب المحجن, who dragged his intestines in the fire, in his stomach, in the hellfire. He dragged it. And he used to steal the belonging of the pilgrims or pilgrims with his covered staff. يعني عنده stick where the top is stick like hook. Okay? He put on his shoulder and go in. When he see the hajjaj holding something, he put his stick hook at the on top of it and hang it. If the owner, no, man, what are you doing? Bill, sorry. If he didn't, he doesn't know anything, he would take it. So, if he, the owner of the staff, became aware, he would say, I got accidentally entangled in my covered staff. Allah, sorry, well, it's hanging my covered staff. But if he was unaware of that, he would take that away. Yalla biyakhadha, yishfutha. For the Prophet saw him in the hellfire. Yu'adhab, punishing, receive torment, severe torment in the hellfire. Well, stealing is a big crime, a big sin. Is it taking the wealth of others? Hada aklu li amwal nas bil batil. And Allah said, وَلَا تَأْكُلُوا أَمْوَالَكُمْ بِالْبَاطِلِ. With one of the reasons to enter the hellfire. Can you tell me about the four big sin, major sin? What is it? Bismillah, beginning. What is it? First one, shirk. How many people fall into the shirk today? Can you say 99%? Yes, 99%. 99%. Who memorize it, who account it? In the hereafter, when Allah Azza wa Jal talk to Adam alayhi salam, oh Adam, bilu labbaik wa sa'daik, bilu akhrij ba'tha nar, take out the people of the hellfire, bilu how much? Kam ya Rab? Bilu min every 1,999. Another ratio from 199 people to the hellfire, one to paradise. Shirk. Number two, what is it? Killing. Killing innocent, like hide the woman killing cat only. What about today? All the news, killing, bombing, ما بعرف شو. القتل ما في إلا الكيلي today. Until the people become cheap. When you get angry with someone, you plan to kill him. Astaghfirullah, what? And number three, what is it? Zina. Adultery. Adultery. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. يعني roughly, do you think a legal section cause among the disbelievers? لا يا حبيبي, among the believers. Among brothers and sisters who praying. Or maybe something in the first line. Who commit adultery with this country. Among the Muslim generation. We don't want to open the file. How many women sleep with someone else behind the back of your husband because your husband not give her her right? Some husband didn't sleep with his wife for 1 month, 2 months. And she's wife, what expect her to do? She will find someone else. Fear Allah. And don't let your wife to go and say to fulfill her desire in the haram way. Watch your daughters, watch your children, what they're doing, especially in junior generation today. Like not adultery only, like something else. Women with women, men with men. Yes, it's appealing the community. For every father, open your eyes. Every mother, open her eyes. See what's going on. Who lost one stealing? What do you think stealing today? People quit, become rich. Habibi, how many jobs do you have? Lala Bilo, I have a different type of business. What kind of business? Tell me, I can increase my money too. بيقول لك هذا الهيريون ومخدرات وحشيش ومشيش والى اخره ودراجز وما دراجز والكحول ويلا وكوكيين وفيين الله اعلم how many names. بيقول لك quick, you can increase your account, your money. لحبيبي انت ودي لا حاضر where are you living? Lay under the eyes of Allah عز وجل. Let the angels with you, wherever you go. Wallah, the earth itself will be against you. يوم إذن تحدث أخبارها بأن ربك أوحى لها. Don't think that you are smart when you look left or right. No one see me. With you, the angels, and Allah too, and the ground, and everything will be witness against you in the earth, يا مسكين. وجاءت كل نفس معها سائق وشهيد. لقد كنت في غفلة من هذا فكشفنا عنك غطاءك فبصرك اليوم حديد. تفضل, have a look. يوم ينظر المرء ما قدمت له, he will see himself how he's stealing, how he's drinking, how he's selling the drugs and the... way after and away that day, مسكين, راح, finish. He lose his life and the hereafter. So wake up, wake up. This warning through this eclipse is a warning to everyone. Enough is enough. Come back to your Lord. Wallahi, this eclipse out of his mercy towards the sinners. I don't want to let the sinners give up. Laya Habibi, don't be scared. Like here, it's warning from Allah to you. When you go to the doctor, be like, Habibi, make sure that you have cancer. But what? You have cancer. What is the best medicine? I ready to pay all my money to heal me, to cure me. Be okay. You still have a chance, yes. For those who commit sin plus sin, don't run away from your Lord. La wallahi, you'll not be able to save yourself from him unless you run towards him. Fafirru ila Allah. Fafirru ila Allah. Tell you something. قال الله عز وجل إن الله يحب التوابين ويحب المتطهرين. Indeed, Allah love those who repent, those who purify themselves. Don't run away from him. Come. لله لله أشد فرحا بتوبة عبده من أحدكم بناقته. Allah عز وجل more happy than the one he have camel or his camel, his food drink, we lost it in the desert. يعني he's waiting the death. Then he find it. How much he's happy. He happy so much. Allah more happier than him when his servant repent and come back to him. Don't be scared from Allah. Love him, go towards him. He will not reject you. He will accept you. He loves you. يحب التوابين. التوابين, the one who repent. يلا repent, repent, repent. After each sin, repent, repent. وat the end, في حجة الوداع, النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم collected all four sin and he said, the messenger of Allah said to his companion, do not associate anything with Allah. هذا الشرك. لا تشركوا بالله شيئا. No commit unlawful intercourse. ولا 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 تزنوا. And nor take a life which Allah has made prohibited except for what is required in law. In the law. يعني legally. If someone kill someone, yeah, we have right to kill him. Not me and you. الرولا. And no steal. No steal. لا تشركوا بالله شيئا. ولا تقتل نفس التي حرم الله بالحق. ولا تزنوا. ولا تسرقوا. فلنتق الله ربنا. ولنحاسب أنفسنا. ولنتجنب موجبات سخط الله وأسباب دخول النار. أسأل الله عز وجل أن يوفقنا لفعل الخيرات واجتناب المنكرات. إنه ولي ذلك والقادر عليه. صلى الله وسلم وبارك على عبده ورسوله محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. جزاكم الله خيرا.